Get rid of your diabetes. Today, there are at least 20 million people living with diabetes in America, and the sad part is that it is possible to prevent and heal pre-diabetes and diabetes type 2 naturally with balanced nutrition and basic exercise. People at risk of getting the disease drop by a staggering 60% if they manage to lose just 10 pounds by following a healthy diet and engage in regular exercise such as walking, according to a report published in the New England Journal of Medicine. May 3, 2001. Pre-diabetes. This term means that you are at risk for getting type 2 diabetes and also heart disease. The good news is if you have pre-diabetes, you can reduce the risk of getting diabetes type 2 and even return to normal blood glucose levels if you follow the guidelines in this article. Type 2 diabetes. Formerly called adult onset diabetes, this is the most common form of diabetes. This form of diabetes usually begins with insulin resistance, a condition in which the body cannot use insulin properly. People can develop this type of diabetes at any age, and is usually associated with today's modern lifestyle of fast food, stress, and no exercise. Being overweight and inactive increases the chances of developing type 2 diabetes dramatically. Traditional treatment includes taking diabetes medicines, aspirin daily, and controlling blood pressure and cholesterol with prescription drugs. But with modest weight loss and moderate daily physical activity, you can delay or even prevent type 2 diabetes and lead a normal life. Let's look at a few steps you can use straight away in your daily life that will make a big difference to your condition. Strength training. Researchers have reported a 23% increase in glucose uptake after 4 months of strength training. Because poor glucose metabolism is associated with adult onset diabetes, improved glucose metabolism is an important benefit of regular strength exercise. Nowadays, you do not have to live in a gym to put on functional muscle. Short high-intensity sessions performed once a week is all that is required to improve glucose metabolism and lose weight. The strength training technique I use requires just 20 to 30 minutes per week. Gone are the days of the 5-day-a-week program with 6 to 12 sets per body part. That method has never worked. One short intense strength training workout a week will elevate your metabolism more than you ever thought possible. The two main components of this technique are the intensity of the exercise and the recovery after the exercise. Infrequent, short, high-intensity weight training sessions, followed by the required amount of time to recover and become stronger, is what is needed to increase functional lean muscle and improve glucose metabolism. Nutrition. The way to lose body fat and maintain muscle is to have a food program for life. Quality food and more energy output are the basics you'll need to go for. Bulk foods that fill you up and don't fill you out, foods that are low in fat and sugar, which aren't refined, should be the ideal. Small frequent meals should be consumed during the day, each containing a little protein to maintain muscle and energy levels. Foods with vital vitamin and mineral supplements should also be taken on a daily basis. A high-quality broad-spectrum vitamin and mineral supplement should also be taken on a daily basis. As before, get the calories from high-quality food, but if you can't, utilize a blender to make concoctions from skim milk with whatever additives you want to use, just as long as you keep count of the calories for your daily total. Now use these blender mixtures and solid food for your daily feedings. Spread it out over many small meals a day instead of the traditional 3 meals a day. The way to keep track of weight loss is to buy a calorie counter and record your daily calorie intake for a week. Exercise. Fat is burned from the body when cells oxidize to release energy in the form of exercise. When the exercise is done slowly to moderately, then the majority of energy is taken from the fat stores. The key to effective aerobic training that burns off maximum fat is long-term consistency, not intensity. It doesn't matter if you run a mile, jog a mile, or walk a mile, you will burn exactly the same amount of calories. The best exercise by far for the purpose of fat loss is fast walking, either indoors on the treadmill or outdoors. Other aerobic activities are the treadmill, bike, climber, or any other training gear found in or out of the gym. You can do a lot to lower your chances of getting diabetes. By exercising regularly, reducing fat from your diet and losing weight can all help you reduce the risk of developing type 2 diabetes.